This week on gaming news, Assassin's Creed Rogue PC specs revealed, Warhammer End Times Vermintide announced, and new Rise of the Tomb Raider details. Hi there guys, and welcome to this week's gaming news. For this episode, we are going single players all the way, so no MMOs this time, just because I think nothing really meaningful has happened in that area this week. Anyway, let's start off with the release date and system requirements reveal for Assassin's Creed Rogue on PC. But before we get into that, some quick information about the game for those of you that don't know about it just yet. The game was initially released last year on Xbox 360 and PS3, and it is the 8th game in the series, acting as a sequel to Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag and a prequel to Assassin's Creed 3, putting the story between those two timelines in 18th century during 7 years war. You play as an ex-assassin, now turned Templar. Gameplay is similar to that of Black Flag, with naval exploration and combat, as well as third-person land exploration and combat, but with some new features as well. Minimum requirements have been revealed and are as follows. We don't have the recommended specs at this time, but I would think it's better not to try and run the game with the minimum hardware, but better upgrade a bit, judging from last year's disaster that was Assassin's Creed Unity. The game is set for March 10th, 2015 release, assuming there are no delays. Next, we have a new announcement for Warhammer Universe. Warhammer End Times Vermintide has been announced earlier this week, and it is a co-op FPS for 4 players that will challenge them with hordes of Skaven, rat people that infested the city of Umbershake, fighting them off across the range of environments stretching from the top of Mango's Tower to the bowels of the Under Empire. The game is due out this year on PC, PS4 and Xbox One. And last for today, we have some new information about the next Tomb Raider game, Rise of the Tomb Raider. The game is going to be a timed Xbox One exclusive, meaning we will probably get it eventually on other platforms, just not straight away. This time the game will take place across at least 2 different locations, with hub areas that are said to be 2 to 3 times larger than in the last game. There is going to be more focus on environment itself, meaning enemies will react to different weather patterns and time of day, and the environment itself is described as the game's main antagonist. Lara will have more tools at her disposal and will be able to pre-plan before engaging in combat, use different bow types, yes guys, bows are back, and she will be able to lure or distract enemies. And of course there is also puzzles and tombs to explore. And that is all we know about the game so far. So that's it for this week's news, I hope you guys liked it. As always, links to my sources are in description. As you can see, I'm continuing to improve upon my visuals for the show, so any feedback you guys can provide would be of great help, I'm sure. But anyway, I hope you all have a wonderful week, and I will see you guys next time. I hope you guys enjoyed my content, and if so, feel free to show your support by commenting, liking or subscribing. Also check out these 2 links for more of my content. Click the first video to check out my Styx Master of Shadows series. Click the second video to check out my Risen 3 series.